They put their heart in building the organization. So I might have missed many names, but I remember these people all considered themselves as part and parcel of the organization to contribute in building this institution. And you are giving number of, you know, memories. And they did not ask whether the teacher has got any memory. Not for the chocolate, but really. But actually, when the thing is going on, I was thinking, suppose a question is asked. And another thing, they asked, where are the places the students spend their time? So two, three incidents come to me. I do not remember which batch it is. So one phone call came telling that, professor, severe ragging is going on in your institute. I said, in Padradina, ragging, never it can be. I told the parent, never it can be. Then I told in the afternoon, 1 o'clock to 2 o'clock interval, I go around and see if the ragging is going on, nothing is happening. Then the parent told me, ragging is not in your premises. You just cross across the road. And in the near the cereal portal where all the sand, everything is there, big ragging is going on. Then some parents said, what happened? They were asked to eat a mud and then lie there. So many things she the mother went on telling me. I was surprised, I was shocked also. How it can be? Next day morning, I called the students and sent a message that whoever was subjected to ragging come. And ragging is what? The people who are doing the ragging, for them it is fun. For the person who is getting it, it is called ragging. So ragging means if the person who gets it feels that it is ragging only. You cannot tell that I was doing a fun. Fun means whether the other people consider as a fun, then it is a fun. Otherwise, it is not a fun. So I called the people, and what I did was, I asked the Castro. You are there, Castro? Then Castro bought the register, admission register. Admission register has photo of all the students. Then I told the junior who were ragged, from these photos, find out who ragged you. And that was in the hall where we first used that fifth floor hall. I made all the people sit there. They identified. This person was the person who asked me to eat to the mud. This person wrote everything. So I got around 30, 40 letters by telling this is what happened. Then I told the people, now you can go. Then whose photograph was there, I called all the people, put up a notice. These 40 people are required to assemble in the seminar hall. So all the 40 came. Then I asked them to sit little away. Gave one paper to them. Then I told them, I have got sufficient proof you did dragging. I give you a plain paper. You have to write what all things you did in dragging, give in a descriptive way. I have already got the photo, everything is identified. If you tell the truth, you will not be removed from the institute. But if you tell a lie, it will end up in removing from the institute. And they were looking around, because every person has to write what he did ragging, and also who were along with him to do the ragging. So I can make out whether anything they are lying or not. Then afterwards, no, they go in writing. And they give more description than the people who immediately I put up a notice. The 40 people are suspended from the institute from with immediate effect. Within 1 hour, parents all started coming, running. What happened? Why, principal, you are playing with the life of our kids. I said, where I am playing with the life of your kid? Then anyhow, after 3 days, no, we took them back. And all the things, no, you know that. Whatever punishment is there, it is. Okay, at every age, people will have their own behavior, and we cannot be so cruel. So after 3 days they were taken, but I remember afterwards the ragging came down very, very drastically. This was one incident I carefully remember. And another I remember is about one faculty. That faculty named some party or somebody, party. And that is a very, very, I remember, because that is very much connected with the value system and the support we get from the fathers in running the institution. Because many of you may not be knowing to what extent the fathers are involved in the culture, in the system. So this is a particular item I want to tell because very closely connected. One day a phone came. I want to talk to Professor Patil. I said, I am not Professor Patil. But I want to talk to him. But then for what purpose you want to talk? What is the message you want to give? So day after tomorrow, there is computer programming one examination. I want a question paper of that. I said, day after tomorrow's paper, question paper, how you want to get today? So he told me, I heard that the question paper can be purchased from him. I said, that is very good. So you do one thing, you give your address. And I will give the number also, and later on we can contact him. So he did not give the number. He told that I am from Bharatiya Vidya Peeth, from Nerul or somewhere. I want to meet. For me, what happened? Even though I am not a very courageous, but anything very immoral or not good happening, I cannot tolerate. I become restless. So even though university accept the examiner, we are not directly connected. I feel very bad. One of our faculty selling question paper. Father Agnal teacher selling question paper. I cannot accept it. I rushed to father. Father means not my father. Father Dini. I rushed to Father Dini and told Father Dini, Father, this is what is happening. Father immediately telephoned one Fernandez, not our sitting Fernandez. This is one detective Fernandez. So he is a private detective. So a private detective Fernandez came. Then father told, you have got a work, you have to purchase one question paper, we will give the address to you. And then father gave him 10,000 rupees also. And then told him, you go to Patil's house, address was given. And next day, early morning, detective came. Detective has got a question paper with him. This is a manuscript, handwritten manuscript. And he gave it to me. This is a question paper. Then what happened? Yesterday, when that 8 o'clock in the night, I introduced myself as the father of a student of Bharatiya Vidyapeeth. Then he not only gave the question paper, he gave me tea also. Then I gave him 10,000 rupees. He is a question paper. Then I telephoned Dr. Snehlata Deshmukh. She was the vice chancellor. And you know one thing, I worked with the five vice chancellors, five director of technical education, 10 AICT chairman. Because their tenure is generally 5 years. My tenure was 22 years. So, Dr. Snehlata Deshmukh, you may be knowing, very fine lady. So, I talked to her. Madam, question paper has leaked out. No, don't believe that. Sometime, whatever the question paper that you have got, maybe a fake question paper. The person who has given the question paper might have cheated. Then I said, Madam, is it not necessary that you have to verify? Okay. Then I remember, I think Prabhu took, I think. You took the question paper, I think. I said, we have to go to university and give the manuscript. So, Prabhu went there. And there, the examination question paper is lock and key. Even though outside it is Xerox, inside it is under lock and key. And there is two keys. One key will be kept by the registrar, another by the controller of examination. And I tell you, the question paper was opened and the question paper taken out and compiled. It was ditto same question paper. So vice chancellor told, now day after tomorrow is the examination. Now what can be done now? So I telephoned Kranti Kumar. Kranti Kumar was the principal in Taduman Shahi. He's my friend. Then I told him, you are teaching computer programming. Can you set one question paper immediately? Yes sir, I can do. Then I told Vice Chancellor, you please arrange an appointment order. Kranti Kumar will be giving the question paper. And that day evening, question paper was given. And next day when the examination was there, examination was conducted properly. Then suddenly to my room, Professor Patil entered my room. He said, Dr. Iyer, you know the university is a cheat. I said, how university is a cheat? Because they changed my question paper. Professor Patil, yesterday evening, what you were doing? I was home only. I tell you, so many people purchase question paper from you. Why? Are Patil, one of the person who purchased question paper from you is from CBI. You are suffering. Fortunately, at that time, one constable was walking through the veranda to enquire something about admission. That, maybe, then I told party, that CBI will put a case against you and the whole thing will be in a big problem for you. Your whole life will be in peril. Therefore, it is better that I can help you if you want. Then how he can help you? You escape from here. You simply escape. And how will you escape? Give a resignation letter and escape. Then when the police come, I can say, he was a faculty. You escape. Then immediately I went to Father Denis and told that this is the thing and got a resignation letter and got it, he removed from the system. Then, because I know in university, you know, suppose we put up a case, it may take a long time and inquiries will come, tribunal will come, and by that time he will become professor and become principal also maybe. I don't wonder, I saw that. Why I'm telling you now, simple thing. Whether it is a discipline, some of you, I don't know, whether some of the batches, somebody were detained, and if the attendance was low, somebody not done, coping was, whenever found out, was strictly dealt with. So, some value system, that is some principles, was always maintained by the institute. And this institute was a shared value. Our faculty, our laboratory staff, pews, our fact, including up to father to all the people, there was a general guiding value system. So afterwards I joined SPN Institute as director and I am continuing as a professor, but still I relate myself as the principal of Father Adana as the main job that I was been doing. To get an opportunity to be a founder principal, as you called, will be a very great privilege, even though the institute is built by all the faculty who are here. And I take this opportunity to extend sincere thanks to all the people. So, thank you. I wish a great success to all of you and a great time ahead to all of you. And I hope that wherever you are, this great value system will be upheld. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Iyer, for sharing your words of encouragement and your memories back from college days.